Good day and welcome back. Today's video, we're going to talk about current density, electric conductivity, and resistivity. So the learning outcome of today's video, including define electric current and conductivity, and learn about the equations of the J equal to sigma E. And then we're also going to derive the equations for the conductivity, define resistivity, and prove the equivalence between Ohm's law and the J equal to sigma E. So first of all, we're going to look at the current density, where it is defined as the ratio of the current and the cross-sectional area of the conductor. So the symbol is given as J, and it is equal to I over A. And we also learned that I is equal to nav in the last topic. So we can substitute the formula, and we could also express J is NVE. Next thing is about the electrical conductivity that defined as the ratio of the current density to the electric field strength, where sigma is equal to J over E. So we have another expression for the current density equal to sigma E. So take note that there's a three formulas for the current density that we could find in this section. Next, we're going to look at the relationship between the electric conductivity and the resistivity. Before that, let us review back the mechanism of the electric conduction. First of all, when we apply the potential difference across the conductor, so there's an electric field set up in the conductor. So we learn about the electric field strength is equal to the voltage divided by the distance, or we can also express it as the voltage divided by the length of conductor. So we learn that when there's an electric field, so we have the electrostatic force that act on the charge in the field. So the force is defined as QE, and since we are talking about the electron, so we can express the force as the charge of electron multiplied the electric field strength. Another thing that we learned before is when there's force, so the electron will accelerate. Then we can express the drift velocity as AT. So we can further derive the formula for the drift velocity, where the acceleration is the ratio of the force to the mass of electron. And then we can substitute the expression for the force as EE. And you could get the equations of the V equal to electron charge multiplied ET divided by M. With this information, now we're going to derive the equations for the conductivity. First of all, we have the definitions of the sigma as J over E, or the sigma E equal to J. And we also have learned that the current density is NVE. So we could replace the V as the formula that we have derived and rearrange the formula, and you could get the equations of the sigma equal to N E squared T over M. So after the derivations, now we're going to look at the difference between the conductivity and the resistivity. Electrical conductivity also can be defined as the measure of the material to conduct and electric current, while for the resistivity, you have learned it before, it is the measure of the material to oppose the flow of electric current. So here you can see that the conduct is the opposite to the word oppose. So here we have the relationship of the conductivity is actually also the reciprocal of resistivity. And then we're going to do some little revisions on the resistance that you have learned before, where you're given the formula of R equal to the resistivity multiplied the length divided by the cross-sectional area of the conductor. So from here, you could rearrange the formula and you could get the formula of the resistivity. Next, we are also going to revise about the Ohm's law. It states that the current through a conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference across the conductor. So we have the relationship of the current directly proportional to V, and we have the formula of V equal to IR from the Ohm's law. Another thing that you have learned is about the ohmic conductor that obeys the Ohm's law. When you plot the graph of I against the V, so you would get a linear graph for the ohmic conductor where the gradient is the reciprocal of the resistance, which is a constant value. After we learn about the Ohm's law, now we're going to prove the relationship with the J equal to sigma E. So there's a few versions of solutions to prove the relationship. But for my part here, I will start with the Ohm's law, where V equal to IR. From here, how we can relate the formula with J equal to sigma E. So the key variable is about the current, which we have just learned in this chapter. We know that the current density J is defined as the ratio of the current to the cross-sectional area. So we could express I as JA. And then we also could get the electric field strength as the V over L. So we can divide both sides with the length of the conductor. And here you could replace the V over L as the electric field strength. And then the RA over L, which we just seen it before, which is the resistivity. And then we move the resistivity to the other side, where the reciprocal of the resistivity is the conductivity. So now you can see that the Ohm's law V equal to IR is equivalent to the equations of the J equal to sigma E. So that's a lot of equations you can learn from these few topics. So kindly do revisions on the derivations and also the formula to master this topic. So that's all for my discussion today. So if you have any questions, you can leave in the comment section below. Also, do leave a like and subscribe my channel. I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.